What's up, y'all? Welcome back. I am Patrick B. Smith, and we are back at my group, my band, Queen. Man, it has been a minute, I know, but I just had to kind of resurface. I had to kind of just step back for a bit because social media sometimes is draining. You know, I had to get into the real world and live my life for a little bit, so I kind of backed off social media for a bit, but I'm here. I'm back, y'all, so sorry for the delay. But I definitely want to get back into my reaction, especially over Queen, because there's a long journey to get through with this band. And I even started to do a little memoir series I'm writing, where I write about certain songs that I grew up in affecting me and inspired me and influenced me. And I have a few years I'm into in the 80s, and I'm writing about Queen, and I'm like, I totally forgot that was them. I'm discovering so many new songs by Queen that I did not know, and I'm so excited to get reactions on them as well. But there is a song called Play the Game, which is from their The Game album, which I believe is in the 80s, that I've never heard. But I do feel that doing songs by Queen and songs that I've never heard is really helped expose a creative side of Queen that I knew they had, but it's just really those deeper cuts that maybe most people don't talk about are the ones I'm really appreciating. Because I'm telling you something, this group is bigger than I thought they were. You know, I think because we have so many massive songs that everybody knows, and that's kind of what defines Queen. But to go deeper in their actual catalog, it's like insane. So definitely excited about that. And I do have some headphones now, so I'm excited to get into the whole journey with this, so I can experience the full vocal experience and band's performances. So this is again Queen singing Play the Game. Like, comment, and subscribe, and see you on the other side. We'll be right back. Y'all are crazy if you don't think Queen is one of the greatest bands in the entire world. First of all, that song. I love that song. Okay, let's get past a few things here. This band, when I always tell you many times, are all equally as important as the other person, because the way they all shined. Bravo, Queen. So obviously Freddie comes in and he's on that piano, and I love the fact that this man can equally play magic on those keys and open that voice, and his voice is incredible. I was not expecting him to climb octaves like that so fast. The power in his vibratos are so crisp. The man is one of the greatest singers. I'm so happy I know that now. What was I thinking going this long and not knowing that? Because his charisma is one thing, but I love, again, the energy from everybody. I even like the effects of the lights. I like when it went over to Brian, you know, and he was kind of letting us see a little sample of what was to come. But as soon as my boy Roger, when I say he took the drums to the next level, I was like, ooh, merge right over to John, coming right in there with Brian. That was an amazing, amazing transition between them. And then went right back at the end after Brian did what he did, back to Freddie, who closed it. That is an experience. That is a performance. That's when you hear people say somebody sang on stage at the award show or somebody performed on stage. It's a clear, distinct difference. They perform. So hail, all hail to Queen for life. Many more to come. I love that. If you have requests, let me know otherwise. Appreciate y'all as always. Like, comment, and subscribe.